Welcome to the Daily Mass from St. Anne's Basilica in Scranton, Pennsylvania. The Passionist community of St. Anne's Monastery is happy to bring you this celebration of the Mass to enhance your daily devotions. May God hear your prayers today and grant you His abiding peace.
Opening song can be found in your Breaking Bread Missal, number 683, I Know That My Redeemer Lives.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Jesus speaks to all of us today, inviting us into a closer relationship with Him. If we only listen and respond, but sometimes we don't do that because of our inclination to sin. So let us acknowledge this and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You're sent to the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call us from our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You see the right of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy upon us. Forgive us our sins and bring us all to everlasting life. Let us pray. Show favor, O Lord, to your servants, and mercifully increase the gifts of your grace, that, meet fervent in hope, faith, and charity, they may be ever watchful in keeping your commands. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. This word of the Lord came to me. Go, cry out this message for Jerusalem to hear. I remembered the devotion of your youth, how you loved me as a bride, following me in the desert, in a land unsown. Sacred to the Lord was Israel, the first fruits of his harvest. Should any presume to partake of them, evil would befall them, says the Lord. When I brought you into the garden land to eat its goodly fruits, you entered and defiled my land. You made my heritage loathsome. The priest asked not, where is the Lord? Those who dealt with the law knew me not. The shepherds rebelled against me. The prophets prophesied by Baal and went after useless idols. Be amazed at this, O heavens, and shudder with sheer horror, says the Lord. Two evils have my people done. They have forsaken me, the source of living waters. They have dug themselves cisterns, broken cisterns, that hold no water. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Disciples approached Jesus and said, "Why do you speak to the crowd in parables?" He said to them in reply, "Because knowledge of the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven has been granted to you, but to them it has not been granted. To anyone who has, more be given, and he will grow rich. From anyone who has not, even what he has will be taken away. This is why I speak to them in parables, because they look, but do not see, and hear, but do not listen or understand. Isaiah's prophecy is fulfilled in them, which says, 'You shall indeed hear, but not understand. You shall indeed look, but never see. Gross is the heart of this people. They will hardly hear with their ears. They have closed their eyes, lest they see with their eyes, and hear with their ears, and understand with their hearts, and be converted, and I heal them. But blessed are your eyes, because they see, and your ears, because they hear. Amen, I say to you, many prophets and righteous people long to see what you see, but didn't see it, and to hear what you hear, but did not hear it." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The story is told about a woman and her son. She taught him well. Talked about the ways of God, and he often spoke about the goodness of God. But then he went off to college, and things began to change. When he came home, she didn't recognize him because he was all dressed differently. And he did not speak about God. And she said, "Son, what about God in your life?" And he says, "Mom, I can't believe anymore. Who is this God? Can you see him? Can you touch him?" It broke her heart. And that night, as they went off to bed, she prayed. And as she prayed, she heard a cry from his room. And as a good mother, she ran to his room. And he was in pain. And she said, "Son, what is wrong?" And said, "Ma, it's the pain." And he said, she got an inspiration. She said, "Can you see the pain? Can you touch the pain?" He said, "How do you know the pain is there?" He says, "Every now and again, I feel it moving up and down my face." I said, "Son, you remember this evening? You asked me about God? And you said, 'Can I see God? Can I touch God?' No, but every now and again, I feel him moving up and down my heart." You see, that mother is like us. Challenges sometimes overwhelm us. And it's Jesus speaking to us in parables. All we have to do is turn our hearts and listen so we can feel him moving every now and again in our hearts. And then we can see, and we can see resolution come in our lives. Challenges are faced as they are bound. Mental illnesses, addictions, family problems. What do you feel now? What troubles you so much that Jesus is speaking to you in parables and you seem to understand? Maybe he's inviting the closer relationship with him so that you can connect with him at a deeper level and feel him moving in your heart. As we gather here, we gather under silent but profound presence of Saint Joseph. The prayers of Saint Anne and God speaking us through word and sacrament. So as you come to the Eucharist today, you open your mouth so you can feel God coming into your lives and filling us with his love, that you can begin to find resolution and peace. Not tomorrow, but right now. Because now is a time of salvation. This is the day the Lord has made. So let us be glad and rejoice in it. Amen. Please rise and let us offer our prayers to our loving God, constantly hears and addresses them.
For the intentions of all those praying the Novena to Saint Anne, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peaceful resolution of all conflicts currently being solved by violence, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are sick in any way, especially those with chronic illnesses, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the welfare of our Commonwealth and our nation, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord God, these are the prayers, those spoken aloud and those in the silence of our hearts. We address them to you, God, knowing that you'll address them in your own time, according to your holy will, because you ask them through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Our song during preparation can be found in your Breaking Bread Missal, number 687, Keep in Mind.
Is that my sacrifice and yours may be something to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, our Lord and the Holy Church.
Oh God, in the one perfect sacrifice brought to completion varied offerings of the law, accept, we pray, the sacrifice from your faithful servants and make it holy as you bless the gifts of Abel. So what is offered to the honor of your majesty may benefit the salvation of all through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Father, most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your worth, whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so, with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim.
Our Father, our God, our Father, 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 our
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you need of it, for this is my body to be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, to drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the more of the death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking the body and blood of Christ may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together, Francis, our Pope, and Joseph, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, though the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, Saint Paul the Cross, and all the saints of peace throughout the ages, may merit to be coherent to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Amen. At the Savior's command, formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil." Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
In the kingdom, the power, and the glory of yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Gracious to be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you so much for coming. Have a wonderful day. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth. The Eucharist has ended.
Thanks be to God.
Our closing song can be found in your Breaking Bread Missal, number 127, Holy Patron, the Salute.
Happy Saint, and so do. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Incline unto my aid, O God.
O Lord, make haste to help me.
Let us pray. Almighty God, Father of mercies and giver of all good gifts, we kneel before you to honor you and your saints, and to seek their intercession in our many needs. We are truly sorry for all our sins, and humbly ask your pardon. Please grant our petitions and a full measure of the indulgences granted by your vicar, the Pope, and draw us ever near your divine heart. Amen. Prayer to Saint Anne, Mother of the Blessed Virgin Mary. With a heart full of sincere and filial veneration, I prostrate myself before you, O Blessed Saint Anne. You are that beloved and privileged creature who, because of your extraordinary virtue and sanctity, did deserve of God that chief of graces, of giving life to the treasury of grace, the blessed among women, the mother of the incarnate Lord, the Blessed Virgin Mary. Ah, in consideration of such exalted favors, please, O most tender saint, receive me among the number of your truly devoted servants, for such I profess myself to be and wish to remain for the rest of my life. Surround me with your efficacious patronage and obtain for me from God the imitation of those virtues with which you are so profusely adorned. Obtain from me a knowledge of my sins and sorrow for them, an ardent love of Jesus and Mary, and a faithful and constant observance of the duties of my state in life. Save me from all dangers in life, and assist me in the hour of my death, that I may safely reach paradise, there to praise with you, most happy Mother, the Word of God made man in the womb of your purest daughter, the Blessed Virgin Mary. Amen. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. This word of the Lord came to me. Go, cry out this message for Jerusalem to hear. I remembered the devotion of your youth, how you loved me as a bride, following me in the desert, in a land unsown. Sacred to the Lord was Israel, the first fruits of his harvest. Should any presume to partake of them, evil would befall them, says the Lord. When I brought you into the garden land to eat its goodly fruits, You entered and defiled my land. You made my heritage loathsome. The priests asked not, where is the Lord? Those who dealt with the law knew me not. The shepherds rebelled against me. The prophets prophesied by Baal and went after useless idols. Be amazed at this, O heavens, and shudder with sheer horror, says the Lord. Two evils have my people done. They have forsaken me, the source of living waters. They have dug themselves cisterns, broken cisterns that hold no water. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. The disciples approached Jesus and said, "Why do you speak to crowds in parables?" He said to them in reply, "Because knowledge of the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven have been granted to you, but to them it has not been granted. To anyone who has, more will be given, and they will grow rich. From anyone who has not, even what they have will be taken away. This is why I speak to them in parables, because they look but do not see, they hear but do not listen or understand. Isaiah's prophecy is fulfilled in them, which says, 'You shall indeed hear, but not understand. You shall indeed look, but never see.' Gross is the heart of this people. They will hardly hear with their ears. They have closed their eyes, lest they see with their eyes, and hear with their ears, and understand with their hearts, and be converted, and I heal them. But blessed are your eyes because they see, your ears because they hear. Amen, I say to you, many prophets and righteous people long to see what you see, but did not see it, to hear what you hear, but did not hear it. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning, everyone. And once again, thank you for not leaving me alone today. Today we consider a rather interesting, I think, title of St. Joseph. St. Joseph, patron of the dying. And so we might ask the question, how might we go about looking and considering St. Joseph as patron of the dying? Well, first, let's put a few things in perspective. The devotion to St. Joseph came about rather slowly in the early church, perhaps because there's so little known about him. Early Christian stories originating in Syria and Egypt around the year 150 depicted St. Joseph as an old man, a widower, who married the Virgin Mary and faithfully cared for her and Jesus. However, scholars today generally dismiss this characterization. Their conclusion is that St. Joseph was likely a young man, perhaps just a few years older than Mary, and not previously married. We also know, thanks to Luke's gospel, that Joseph was still present in the life of Jesus and Mary when Jesus was 12. At the end of the second chapter of Luke is the story of Jesus remaining behind in Jerusalem after the family had journeyed there to celebrate the Passover. It was Mary and Joseph who returned to Jerusalem and to find Jesus in the temple. Words that end that chapter, Jesus went down with them, Mary and Joseph, and came to Nazareth and was obedient to them. And his mother kept all these things in her heart. And Jesus advanced in wisdom, age, and favor before God and man. This story offers the last glimpse of St. Joseph in Jesus' life. However, in Joseph's absence from Jesus' public ministry, we can draw the conclusion that St. Joseph may have died sometime before Jesus began his public ministry, leaving Mary and Jesus to make the rest of life journey on their own. When and how Joseph died is a mystery. Was it a prolonged illness? Was it a sudden death? Might it have been an accident because of his work? How and when Jesus died is not as important from my perspective as that his death must have weighed heavily on Mary and Jesus and his friends, as it would any wife, family, son, daughter, or friend. I'm sure Joseph carried the burden of wondering who would care for Mary and Jesus, perhaps during his illness. Joseph may have even had feelings of helplessness, wondering why this was happening at this moment. We might sense that Joseph went through all the human struggles and challenges that death presents, concern and care for the future of those we love. What will the future bring for them, for us? Are we ready to meet God? We have so much more to accomplish and do, and so on. I think we can safely say that St. Joseph died with dignity and as a faithful person, not fearful, but perhaps in the words of St. Paul, Joseph might have thought, I am hard pressed between death and life, having a desire to depart and be with God, which is far better, but nevertheless to remain in the flesh to be more helpful to you. We might see St. Joseph as a faith-filled man, approaching death in the same way he lived life. He had concern for others and a desire to be with God. Legend and tradition say that St. Joseph died a happy death. And how could it be otherwise? For as we know from his brief appearance in the Gospels, that he served God without question, doing God's work until the end. The journey to death can be one of stress, overwhelming and certainly difficult for everyone involved. In St. Joseph, we have a guide, a friend, a patron, an intercessor, who brings our prayers to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit with the ever-present help of the Blessed Virgin Mary. St. Joseph understands our struggles, our hurts, our pains, our losses, our fear of death. Through his faithfulness, his silent strength, his selfless spirit, we have an anchor holding us firm, so that like him we can hear God's voice, fearing not the darkness and trusting in the eternal light and warmth of God's unconditional love. Good Saint Joseph, patron of the dying, walk with us today and always. Remind us to not be afraid of the darkness of death, and grace us with the wisdom to trust that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor present things, nor future things, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature will be able to separate us from the love of those whom we love, and most importantly, from God's love. Prayer to Saint Anne to obtain a special favor. O glorious Saint Anne, filled with compassion for those who invoke you, and with love for those who suffer, heavily laden with the weight of my troubles, I cast myself at your feet and humbly beg of you to take the present affair which I commend to you under your special protection. And let us silently mention our personal prayer intentions as the petitions are placed at the altar. Please recommend it to your daughter, the Blessed Virgin Mary, and lay it before the throne of Jesus, so that he may bring it to a happy issue. Please continue to intercede for me until my request is granted. Above all, obtain for me the grace of one day holding God face to face with you and Mary and all the saints, praising and blessing him for all eternity. Amen. Good Saint Anne, Mother of her who is our life, our sweetness, and our hope, pray to her for us and obtain our request. Good Saint Anne, Mother of her who is our life, our sweetness, and our hope, pray to her for us and obtain our request. Good Saint Anne, Mother of her who is our life, our sweetness, and our hope, pray to her for us and obtain our request. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Good Saint Anne,
pray for us.
Now I'll take the opportunity to bless any rosaries or religious articles you may have. May these rosaries and religious articles and those who use them be blessed in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
through the intercession of Saint Anne, may Almighty God bless you with continual health in mind and body. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you. Thank you.